Hi everyone, welcome to Java Techie. In this tutorial, we'll discuss how to integrate Apache Camel with Spring Boot to create a REST API. So we already know how to write REST API using Spring Boot. Even we already discussed how we can integrate Spring Boot with Apache Camel. So I will add this link in video description so that you guys can refer it. And in this particular example, I explain the auto routing process of Apache Camel. So we took one example of file transfer from one folder to another folder, and we integrate both Spring Boot with Apache Camel. So let's quickly create a REST example using Apache Camel component, and we are going to use the REST DSL domain specific language. So the code will be more easier and it will be quicker to write the REST API as compared to our traditional approach. So let's get started. To the Eclipse, create a Spring Boot project. So change the project name to Camel REST DSL. Let me remove this description. Change the package here, Spring Camel.api. Click Next. Let's add the required dependency. Let's add the Lombok. Let's add the dev tools. Spring Starter Web, DevTools, and then we are going to add the Camel. So Spring Boot already provided starter dependency for Apache Camel. What else? DevTools, Lombok, Camel, yeah. So click on Next, Finish. So application imported successfully. Let's go to the pom.xml. We are using 2.1.6 and we are getting some compilation error in this version. So let's change it to 4, and we added the dependency here, starter web and dev tools. We used Camel starter and Lombok. Okay, but we need to add couple of dependency to work with Camel component. So let me add these two dependency. We are going to add Camel servlet and we are going to add Camel JSON. Okay. So this is what the Camel servlet and Camel JSON. We are not going to use the dispatcher servlet as we are not writing the Spring REST. Okay. And this Camel JSON dependency will same as our JSON dependency, who will help us to convert object to JSON and JSON to object. So yeah, this is what the dependency we added. So let's take an update. We are good. There is no compilation error in our project. So let's create a package first. So let's create a package called resource, which is similar to our controller. So inside this resource, let's create something like application resource. So this application resource class will be similar like my controller. So let's annotate this with @ component and extend this class from route builder. Then it will ask to override one method, which is configure method, and this configure method is the callback method, and it will call by the Camel component. So first we need to build our Camel component, right? So REST configuration, then build the component, mention the name servlet. You can use the restlet as well, but in this example I am using Camel servlet. Okay, so let's specify the port here. Let me give the port 9090, then specify the host. Let it be localhost. Similarly, we need to specify the binding model. So as this is what we are expecting JSON, so we need to specify REST binding mode dot JSON. Okay. So we build the Camel component. Now here we need to expose the REST API. So REST then your HTTP method type. I want to perform the GET. Then you will find the overloaded method GET and another method with URI. So let me give some URI. Hello world. Then route it and then set the body. Okay, so the body will be always expect here the expression. So let's use the constant. Let me give something like welcome to Java Techie. So if you see the syntax, this will be straightforward and looking very easy, right? So just specify your HTTP method and specify the URL and your expected response. So in this particular one, we hard code the value, right? So and which format you are expecting your response. So you want it to produce media type JSON, right? So you can specify JSON. Add the dot here. Yeah. So we enable the camel servlet and we add the REST endpoint. Now we need to enable the camel servlet in our properties file so that it will allow for any kind of URL. So let's go to our application.properties file. Add the servlet mapping here slash star. Okay. So it should be value. Yeah. And let's specify the port 9090. So we are good. Let's run our application, go to our main class. Let's run a Java application. Yeah, so let me zoom the console. So if you observe, our application is up on port 9090 and it mapped one route. This is what the URL we specify, hello world. We did a mistake here. Yeah, so let's hit this URL. Go to browser. Type localhost, then our URL, let's enter it. So we are able to see the response in JSON format, right? Welcome to Java Tiki. So if you go to the code, let me go to our router. Yeah. So here we specify set body as a expression. So if I have custom object, if I have employee object or product object, how can I populate those value? How can I display those value as a JSON? So let's do one more example by creating our own custom object. So let me stop the server. Let me format this. Yeah. So let's create a custom class. First, let's create a package. Let me create a package something like DTO. So let me zoom this. Yeah. So in DTO, let's create a something class called order. So let's add a few field, private int ID, then name, then price. As we added Lombok, we no need to write getter setter manually. We can add annotation data. And we want all argument constructor, so add it. And we want no argument constructor. Let's add toString. Yeah. So I have a custom object which is order. And we have three field ID, name, price. So let me create one more package called service. Dot service. So name it order service. Annotate this class as a @service. And here I just want to initialize couple of order object to one list so that we can populate those value in our router, right? So let's create a list first. List of order. So let's write a method where we want to initialize the list, public void something like init db. So we can use the database. This is the sample example to expose the REST API. I am not going to use the any database here. So what we can do, we can add in this init db, and we will annotate this with @post construct. So before execute your main method, first it will execute and it will initialize, it will add couple of value to your list. So what we can do, we can add list dot add new order object, give some id like 67, give the name mobile, give the price 5000. Okay, similarly let's add few more object, give some random id, product name book, of amount 400. Similarly give some another object, let's name it SC, and amount 15000. Okay, give something like shoes, of price 4000. Okay, so we added four objects to the list. Now let's write two method, something like, let's write a method for post and get. So let's write public, and I want to return the order object add order, who will take input as order object, and it will add that to the list, and it will return the order object which it will add to the list. Okay, so let's write another method for the get one. So public will return me the list of product object, sorry, order object, get orders, it will directly return the list. So we wrote two methods, one is for post where we are going to add the order object, another one is for get. Okay, so let's go back to our resource. So as we are going to invoke this order service, so we need to inject it, private order service service. Use auto add here. So let me remove this unused import. Now let's write the REST endpoint to get list of order. So the REST and the method type should be get, right? Specify the URL slash get orders. So let me zoom this and let me copy this. We want it to produce JSON. Okay, and we want to set the body. So we are not going to set the expression here. So if you observe, set body is the overloaded method. Go to this supplier. Let me show you that. Go to the source code. Yeah, so if you observe supplier, we know this is what the functional interface, right? The supplier, let me show you that. Yeah, the supplier, predicate, function, all those are the functional interface. So we can go for the lambda. So set body is expecting supplier. So we are using lambda here. It will have only the return type. So that's why there is no method argument in supplier evaluate method. So what we can do, we can use service dot get orders. Right, yeah, so we specify the get method, and we specify the produces expected response type, and we set the body using the lambda expression. Okay, so once you will hit this URL, it will go to your this set body method. Then inside set body method, we are invoking our service layer with get orders. So whatever the order object we have in our service will be attached to your body and it will display, right? So let's test this API. So let me run this application. So we added 4 order object, right? It should display the 4 orders. So let me show you whether the URL is mapped or not. Yeah, so if you observe, we have the URL get orders, which is our route 2. So let's hit this URL, go to the browser, change the URL to get orders. So we are able to see the 4 order object which we initialized in our service layer. So this is what we did for the get method. So how we can do for post method? How we can add order object to list and how we can retrieve it? So let's write a REST endpoint for our post example. So let me stop this server. Let's zoom this. So to write the post method, the Apache Camel approach will be a bit tricky. We can directly add the value using our set body and all. We need one more component, that is processor. Okay, so let's do that. The method REST of type post, and in post let's specify the URL add order. Okay, so then we can specify consumes and produces. So let's specify the consumes, which is our media type JSON. So let me paste this, and then type of response you are expecting, it will return me the order class, right? So what should be your input type is order dot class, and what should be your expected output type? So there is some out type. So you can specify order dot class, so it will return us the order object, right? So let me show you the method once again. Go to our order service, we have the method add order, and it's expecting input as order type and response also order type, right? So that's why I mention type of input and output type. Then route it, and we need to process it. So we didn't create a processor, so we'll create it. So let's create a processor first. Let me save this. So let's create another package. Something like processor. Okay. So go to that package and create another class. So create a class something like order processor. So we need to implement this class from processor interface, which is provided by Apache Camel. Yeah, so if you observe, this is what provided by Apache Camel, and let's override the process method, and we need to add this at the rate component. So in this process method, we'll handle your input. Okay, so in add method, if I will send list of single order object, then it will be handled by this exchange. So in this exchange, you can extract that value and we can add in our service. So let me inject the service here, private order service, service, use auto add. So what we can do in service, we have a method called add order, and where we'll get the order object, we'll extract from this exchange. Okay, so exchange dot get in, then get the body of type order dot class. So in service add order, we are expecting order object to be passed, right? And from this exchange, we extract the body of type order dot class. So the post request will be handled, the value will be populated through this syntax extends dot get in. So let's go to our router. We need to inject this order processor. Okay, so inject this private order processor. So this processor can't be injected through the auto add. So to inject the order processor, as this processor will be callback, it's not our control, it will be invoked by camel component. So we can directly inject this using auto add. So for that there is another annotation provided by camel. Let's use that. So the annotation will be something like bean inject. Yeah. So this order process will be injected in my router. So let me zoom this. So in post method, we need to pass the processor. Here we need to pass the processor. Then we can end our REST. Okay. So once you expose the REST endpoint, it's good to close. Okay, so we created three REST endpoint. Let's close one by one. Yeah. So in post, we just specify the HTTP method with URL, and we specify the consume, and we specify the input type and output type, and we used processor who will extract the field, and from exchange we are getting the raw body, and we are mapping to our service, right? So let me show you that order processor. Yeah, so exchange dot get in dot get body order dot class, and it will give us the order object which will pass from the postman, and it will add. Okay, so let's run our application to test this post API. So go to main class. Yeah, run as Java application. Meanwhile, let me open my Postman. Let's go to the console. Yeah, it's up on port 9090 and it mapped 3 URL. Okay, so this is my route 3. So let's use this URL. Go to Postman. Let me close this. The URL we have. Let's go to any post 9090 and the URL will be add order. So we don't want any authorization here. Let's add the body, ID name, and price. Price something like 7000. Give the ID something like 12. Let's say the name is something like earphone. So let's click on send. So it got saved the order object, right? So let's verify it in our get method so that we can see the 5 order object. So let's go to browser, the URL get orders. Yeah, so we are able to see the object which we added in our list, right? So this is how we can integrate Spring Boot with Apache Camel, and we can expose our REST API. So if you observe the syntax, this will be straightforward with your HTTP method type and URL, and we are just setting the body, right? Yeah, so that's it about this particular video. Even using Apache Camel, we can build microservices. It provided support for Hystrix and load balancing and Cloud Console. So if you guys are interested in it, let me know. I will prepare the video on Apache Camel and microservice. Thanks for watching this video.